Look, John. Jonna saw that the other hole, which had not frosted up again, had become bigger. The ice had melted without the help of a single hot bottle top. Large drops of water ran down the pane, and soon the hole was as large as the lid of the gruel pot. The snow flickered. A storm had whipped up, and there were thousands of snowflakes dancing around in the mirror. And in the eye of the storm, John and Jonna saw a little carriage approaching, drawn by a bee in winter attire. In the carriage sat Her Majesty, the Snow Queen, in a white fur coat with a fur hat on her head and a crown of gleaming ice. She didn't look like a bee at all. She looked more like a person with ice blue eyes, a sharp little nose, and lips that were tightly pressed together. The carriage drew up to John and Jonna. The Snow Queen's face came right up close to them. She had pale, frosty skin, eyes like blue ice crystals, and hair made of icicles that stuck out from under her fur hat. John and Jonna took a step back. Was it true? Did the Snow Queen really exist? They froze, their feet stuck to the floor. The blue glow from the paraffin lamp pulsated like a beacon when the Snow Queen's breath blew cold air into the kitchen. John and Jonna, I've heard about you. Her ice blue gaze cut through the air. Who are you? Stammered Jonna. I am the Snow Queen. Who else would I be? But do you really exist? John managed to blurt out. What does it look like? She spat and blew a whirlwind of snowflakes over the children. She was the queen and mistress of snow and ice, who lived in a winter palace far up in the north. It's obviously 1,000 times the size of this old hovel, but it's starting to get too cramped. I need something bigger. The palace had 100 rooms, with pinnacles and towers. The biggest hall had her throne of ice in it, and an ice crystal chandelier hung from the ceiling with 10 candles burning.